in overnight storms, leaving a path of destruction all across central Iowa. Heavy rain and high winds toppled trees, damaged buildings, flattened crops, and left thousands of people in the dark. Good afternoon. We have storm team coverage from all across central Iowa.
The path of destruction stretches from northern Polk through Story, Marshall, and Tama counties. Todd Magel's first up with the situation in the town of Garwin. Todd.
Well, Kevin and Cynthia, we are just a few miles north east of Marshalltown in the sort of downtown area of Garwin, and I'll step out of the way. You can see where some of the damage started here on the southwest corner of town. That used to be back in the distance there, about a 60-foot grain elevator. Several of those have been twisted and folded in half as this huge storm moved in this morning. If we pull out what's left of the park in Garwin, just about every tree in this park in the town square has been ripped out of the ground or branches falling off trees. And if Jesse spins around through the downtown area, we head over to what used to be the post office. The roof was blown off early this morning. The post office is closed. No more mail for a while in the town of Garwin. Now, just a few blocks from here, lots more damage to homes in the area. There are about 500 people who live in town. Just about all of them had some kind of damage last night. Lots of downed trees, shingles gone, most roofs damaged, some torn off. Now, there is confusion about actually what happened this morning. Was it straight line winds? Was it a tornado? Still not sure. The sad part is that the power went out here and most of areas around here in Marshall and Tama County, and the sirens, the tornado sirens, didn't go off. We talked earlier to some townspeople and also about the fire chief about what's left of Garwin.
Woke up and found trees laying down on our vehicles, on our house, but everybody's okay, so that's all that matters.
The survey is probably 90% of the homes here in town have been affected. Probably 90% of the trees are down. We are without lights, we're without gas. Those could be days at this point, we don't know for sure.
And the good news we have to say is that despite all the damage, just about every house, as we mentioned, damaged, nobody hurt. People knew this storm was coming because a lot of them were watching News Channel 8, they told me today, and they saw these warnings, and so they were aware of it coming. Of course, this scene playing out all over in this small town. Now, as we mentioned, they think they might have power back maybe in the next 48 hours. It's a hot day. No air conditioning. Alliant Energy is surveying the damage today, and we'll show you why the power is out. We were just outside of town earlier, mile after mile of power lines blown over, just like the corn was blown over. We'll show you that coming up tonight on News Channel 8 at 6. Kevin?
All right. What a scene. Thank you, Todd.
Also hit